joining us for Last Hour Trades. Good afternoon. Ashwani, your thoughts? It's been very volatile today, moving both ways. For Last Hour, what's the call now, and what about your individual stock-specific calls?
Well, the only reason HDFC twins are holding on is so that mid-caps can be sold. The moment that distribution is over, both these guys will also fall. So I don't think that's the right way of looking at life. See, every day we say yesterday was expiry, so things will flush out. Today is Friday, so we'll flush out. Why don't we read the message for what it is? The fact of the matter is, even key supports don't lead to great amount of pullbacks. Number two, you know, mid caps will really go down much, much further than people expect. Why? Because this is the cost of capital rally. And cost of capital rally, several stocks went up, you know, 2,000%. So let's not, make these things very easy. I think financials went up to 40% of weightage, and that needs to come down to an average sector weightage. So given that, the message of the market simply is that there is more downside, there is even more downside on mid cap, small cap, etc. Now again, the point, should you start buying and, you know, think that this is it? You know, market corrections can be deep, and if this is a big cycle correction, which means from 8,000 to, you know, 12,000, basically going back to 10,000, then there's a lot of downside. The best way to deal with this is let the downside play out, because the prices can be very different. DHFL, it used to be a quality stock at 600. So, you know, quality stocks can suddenly become bad stocks. Yes Bank was a quality stock at 400. So which quality stock, you know, gets into trouble, you don't know. So my sense is that this is a point where markets are going down. Either go short or stay away, but don't mess around becoming value investors, as we can see what happened to the value investors of small cap and mid cap. Having said that, I think something is again breaking in PSU banks. PNB is a sell with a stop of 61, target of 55. BOB is a sell with a stop of 104, target of 92. And Asian Paint is a buy with a stop of 1285, target of 1340.
Okay, so going on the negative side on some of the PSU names, that is Ashwani's call for the hour. Mitesh, good afternoon. Again, this has been really, really troublesome, the manner in which, again, the mid-cap market collapsed in the last 1 hour. Your thoughts and, of course, trades.
Afternoon, Surbhi. I think this kind of activity, you might see it happening many a times over the coming few weeks. See, the reason being, and I've been saying this much for last few days, a few weeks, is that the medium and the longer term charts have started to get weak and are now showing clearly signs of correction and profit booking, which means that the one leg of decline might be, you know, happening over there right now, but eventually we will possibly see much lower levels, and we will also see patterns of lower highs and lower lows. So in that sense, I think, you know, the market for the next few months, I would say, looks corrective, and possibly will head downwards. In the short term though, I think we've seen 10,880 play out as some kind of a pivot on the intraday charts. I think day before yesterday we had a similar low. 4 or 5 days back, we had a similar low close to about 10,860. So maybe, you know, we'll just stall for a moment over here. But again, as I said, I think I would be more keen to go short at higher levels. That strategy remains. And on stock specific basis, as breakdowns happen, we are looking at shorting opportunities. So the two stocks which I have on the sell side right now are Century Textiles is a sell with a stop at 848 for targets of 790. It's dipped a bit, so maybe around 828, 830 would be a good level to enter short. And Tata Power is a sell. Keep a stop at 67.5, look for targets close to about 63.
Fair enough. You know,